What for you is the true spirit, the essence of progressive music?
Never being still, always moving forward, and always growing. So that's basically it.
Probably the key for me is in the name itself, the idea of something constantly evolving, constantly progressing, kind of pushing at the vanguard. And I think that the true spirit of prog in the 21st century would be about shifting forwards and maybe thinking about kind of reaching out into other genres and not maybe just drawing upon the traditional sort of prog elements that you might think of, you know, the concept record, the extended solo, the virtuosity. But perhaps I think what I'd like to do is kind of push it a little bit more into the mainstream as well.
Originality, I think that's something that comes from your heart mostly. I think that it's always nice when your inspiration comes from something that you feel, not what you hear or, I don't know, listen to. So talking about the music, everything that is connected with something else than music, it's much more original, and for me, it's my bigger influence for sure.
It's original thought. It's wanting to take chances. There's the cliches can be symphonic or jazz, but I think it's something to do with an experimental mind, really.
It's the absence of boundaries. That's essentially what it is. Do the what the f*** you want, and don't worry about whether you're catering to a market. That's what it really means.
Do it your way. Find your originality. Strive for that originality, and write songs that come from a central place, a real place inside you, so people can connect with them.
Well, for me, it's just not being restricted by the confines of traditional song forms, I guess, which means that progressive can mean any number of things. It wasn't called progressive when I was a kid. It was called underground. And I guess we were all just trying to stretch the form and make it go in other places. So to lump everything together under one banner is a bit of a misnomer, I think.
Well, I think it's trying. Well, for me, it would be, you know, trying to push the envelope. Trying to push the edges of what music is doing. For me, it's very much about introducing new sounds, new ways to, create music that's just fresh and new, and not just kind of doing very well music that people have already done. You know, I like to, in my work in the studio and recording and playing the guitar, I search, you know, for new sounds, you know, and that takes quite a lot to not, you record, you play it back, you listen, that's not it, you know. I'm trying to like break new territory all the time, incorporate some sounds from the modern world, sounds that I've experienced in my life, and try and, you know, really create a new vocabulary with it. I think that's really what it's all about.
Well, the essence of progressive movement, it must do stuff that hasn't been done before. I mean, that's really what progressive means. Now, I mean, you've got to be in the right place at the right time, and it's getting harder and harder because, of course, you have to remember that a lot of it's already been done, whereas when I started, a lot of it hadn't been done. So from that point of view, it's much more difficult for the young artist today to come up with something genuinely new. But, you know, if you've got talent and if you've got a way of doing things that is unlike other people's, you can create something new, for sure.
I think there are traps with it, you know, which is it can be overblown. I think that what progressive music did at its best was to just broaden the format of music, you know, where you were just kind of trapped in verse chorus. You could argue the Beatles were starting to be progressive with the track like Day in the Life, which had a lot of different sections, and it, you know, and so I think it was the form of prog which was the main thing, elasticating the format of music and showing that you can have a long piece with lots of different sections that still has form. It's a bit like, you know, the difference between a short story and a long novel. I mean, you can have a long piece of music that still works. Classical pieces are like that. And I think that what prog tried to do a lot of the time was to have a longer design so you'd have a more fulfilling listen. Maybe not as catchy a listen, but a more fulfilling listen. More colour, more light and shade, more dynamics, you know, perhaps more of a theatrical experience as well. And it got overblown sometimes, and I think people overreached themselves, and it got a bit pompous, and that maybe put people off. But at its best, I think it was a really creative force.
We always want to do something new. I don't entirely believe in prog music, to be truthful. I think that the Beatles and the Stones and Hendrix and all these were prog. They were prog before us. And so when we started, we were just, oh, this is going too long. We were trying to be something different and something new, as were the other bands around us. So that's all we ever wanted to do. So it became known as prog, but that was just a historical thing.
Progressive music has always been around. You know, I always think of Stravinsky as progressive, and jazz music, Miles Davis and the Beatles, and think about Revolver, the White Album, progressive music, and Zappa. And then, you know, Yes came along, and King Crimson, all progressing, evolving. And here we are in the 21st century, still evolving musically. It's kind of a dream come true to still be alive making music.